गुड मॉर्निंग स्टूडेंट्स, लास्ट क्लास वी फिनिश्ड अप टू प्रॉब्लम नंबर 11. प्रॉब्लम नंबर 12 यू सी, टू बॉडीज ऑफ मासेस 1 kg एंड 3 kg हैविंग पोजिशन वेक्टर्स i कैप प्लस 2j कैप प्लस k कैप एंड माइनस 3i कैप माइनस 2j कैप प्लस k कैप रेस्पेक्टिवली, द सेंटर ऑफ मास ऑफ द सिस्टम हैज ए पोजिशन वेक्टर. टू पार्टिकल्स आर देर, देर मासेस आर 1 kg एंड 2 kg 3 kg. सो m1 इज ईक्वल टू 1 kg, m2 इज ईक्वल टू 3 kg. फर्स्ट बॉडी ईज एट द पोजिशन ऑफ, पोजिशन वेक्टर ऑफ फर्स्ट बॉडी i प्लस 2j प्लस k. सो i कैप प्लस 2j कैप प्लस के कैप. पोजिशन वेक्टर ऑफ द सेकेंड बॉडी दे मेंशनड एज माइनस 3i कैप माइनस 2j कैप प्लस के कैप मीटर. फाइंड द पोजिशन वेक्टर ऑफ द सेंटर ऑफ मास, दट इज द क्वेश्चन. So here position vector of the center of mass formula, RCM bar is equal to M1 R1 bar plus M2 R2 bar divided by M1 plus M2. Already they gave M1 R1 M2 R2 values, just you substitute in this formula. Then what we will get, RCM bar is equal to 1 into i cap plus 2j cap plus k cap plus 3 into minus 3i cap minus 2j cap plus k cap divided by 1 plus 3. So here 1, here minus 9. So this will be minus 8i cap 2j minus 4j, 6j means minus 4j, k plus 3k means 4k by 4. So we will get it as minus 2i cap, RCM bar is equal to minus 2i cap, correct, minus j cap plus k cap meter. So option for this 12th question will be minus 2i k minus j cap plus k cap. It will be first option for this. Okay. Next question number 13. A circular disc of moment of inertia it is rotating in the horizontal plane about its symmetric axis with a constant angular velocity omega I. Modify it as omega I. They gave something omega R like that. Modify it as omega I. Another disk of moment of inertia IB is dropped coaxially onto the rotating disk. Initially the second speed has disk has zero angular speed. Eventually both the disks rotate with a constant angular speed omega f. The energy lost by the initially rotating disk to friction is what? So what is the question? See, here one disc is there, its moment of inertia is it. It is rotating about one axis with angular velocity of omega I. There is a disk, its moment of inertia will be it. It is rotating with angular velocity omega I. On that another disc is dropped. So like this, one more disc is dropped on it. Its angular moment of inertia will be IB, and it is having no angular velocity. Then when some mass is, it is rotating some with velocity, no, some angular velocity. When another mass is dropped on it, its angular velocity will decrease. So what is the loss of kinetic energy of the system? That is the question. Here angular momentum will be conserved. So we can write from law of conservation of angular momentum. Law of conservation of angular momentum. I1 omega 1 is equal to I2 omega 2. Here initially only one disk is there. Its moment of inertia will be IT. It is rotating with angular velocity omega I. Later another disk is dropped on it. So here what will happen? IT plus another disk is having zero angular velocity, na? So IT into IT plus IB into omega F square. So final angular momentum will be IT plus IB and omega F value. I am assuming final angular velocity is omega F, not omega F square. Then omega F value, how much we will get? IT omega I by IT plus IB. Let it be equation 1. They are asking what is the change in the kinetic energy of the system, rather loss of kinetic energy due to friction is how much. They are asking initial kinetic energy, if I write 1 by 2 IT, okay, E is equal to 1 by 2 I omega square. So IT omega I square plus 1 by 2 IB, it is at rest, second one. So finally this value will be 1 by 2 IT omega I square. Initially second one is at rest. Later what happened? Both are rotating with the same angular velocity of omega F. Ke final, if we write 1 by 2, total moment of inertia will be IT plus IB omega F square. Omega F value is this one. You substitute here 1 by 2 IT plus IB. Omega F square means IT square omega I square. It's a square, man. IT plus IB whole square. Clear? So here omega F, I am substituting this value. So 1 IT plus IB will cancels. So final kinetic energy, how much we will get here is, KEF is equal to 1 by 2 IT square omega I square divided by IT plus IB. This is final kinetic energy of the system. What is the loss of kinetic energy means? Delta KE is equal to initial kinetic energy minus final kinetic energy. Initial kinetic energy is this one, 1 by 2 IT omega I square minus 1 by 2 IT square omega I square by IT plus IV. Omega I square by 2, you take it as common. Okay? So, or directly 1 by 2 IT omega I square, if you take common, here 1 will comes. Here IT will be there. Here IT plus IB. Take LCM 1 by 2 IT omega I square IT plus IB minus IT by IT plus IB. Just LCM. IT, IT will cancels. IT, IB. So, finally this value 1 by 2 IT, IB omega I square by IT plus IB. This is the loss of kinetic energy of the system when it is dropped, when another disc is dropped on the first disc. So if we check the options, fourth option will be the answer. So 13th question, it will be fourth option. Okay, next 14th question, you see. What they are asking, two particles which are initially at rest are moving towards each other under the action of their internal attraction. If their speeds are v and 2v, at any instant then the speed of the center of mass of the system will be, just like same problem, problem number 10 in the KCET. So same here we will get, because they are moving with the internal forces of attraction, there is no change in the velocity of the center of mass. Initially velocity of the center of mass is zero. Though they are moving, velocity of the center of mass is equal to zero. Here what to write? Here particles are bodies, what they mentioned, particles. Here particles are moving under internal forces of attraction. Particles are moving under internal forces of attraction. Internal forces will not change velocity of center of mass. They won't change the velocity of center of mass. Initially, center of mass is at rest. So, after moving there, they are moving towards each other also, though velocity of center of mass is equal to zero. Initially, VCM is equal to zero. Therefore, finally also, VCM is equal to zero. Already repeated question, 10th question in the CET corner. So option will be second option. 14th question, it will be second option. Next, problem number 15. what they are asking, see. From a circular disk of radius r and mass 9m, a small disk of mass m and radius r by 3 is removed concentrically. The moment of inertia of the remaining disk about an axis perpendicular to the plane of the disk and passing through the center is. How to do this type of problems? See, there is a circular disk like this. Disk means total mass will be there like this. What is its mass? 9m. What is its radius? R. About this axis, if its mass is m, what is its moment of inertia? Means axis, this axis, an axis passing through the center and perpendicular to the plane. Moment of inertia formula, m r square by 2, basic formula. In this, what happened? They removed some mass. They removed a circular portion of radius r by 3. This portion they removed. So what happened? Mass, some mass has decreased. Then again its moment of inertia will also changes. Then the final thing will be this one. Its mass is how much? We don't know. We have to find what is its moment of inertia about the same axis. About the same axis like this. What is the moment of inertia we have to find? So for this type of problems, we have to use I total. Means before removing that circular portion, that moment of inertia, how much it will be there? That will be called I total is equal to I removed. Removed portion is having some center of some moment of inertia plus I remaining. So this part is removed from it. This part we kept like this. So this part moment of inertia plus this part moment of inertia is equal to total moment of inertia of the system. Like that we have to find I remaining. I removed we will calculate, I total we will calculate. From that we will find the I remaining. For that we have to find initially what is its mass. Mass of removed portion. Mass of removed portion is equal to mass per unit area into mass or area of this portion. Mass will be capital M. Area of the total disk will be pi r square. Mass per unit area means M by pi r square. In mass is 9m. So mass per unit area means 9m by pi r square into area of this portion pi into its radius will be r by 3. So what we will get? 9m by pi r square. Pi r square by 9. Pi r square, 9 will cancel. So mass of the removed portion will be equal to m. Radius of the removed portion will be equal to r by 3. So we'll use this formula. First we'll calculate that values. I total. what is the formula if mass is m, radius is r, formula will be m r square by 2. Here mass is 9m, radius is r square by 2. So total moment of inertia will be 9m into r square. I removed also, we will calculate. Removed is also circular disk about the same axis. Formula will be same, m r square by 2. Here mass plays, mass of removed portion will be m, radius will be r by 3 whole square by 2. So this value will be m r square. 3 square will be 9, 9 will come into the denominator. So it becomes m r square by 18. This is moment of inertia of removed portion. This is the moment of inertia of total portion. If we substitute these two values here, we'll get the I remaining. Okay, that will be the answer. So what to do? So here, I total value will be 9mr square by 2. I removed value will be mr square by 18 plus I remaining. So I remaining is equal to 9mr square by 2 minus mr square by 18. So mr square by 2 you take common. Here 9 will be there. Here 1 by 9 will be there. 9 9s are 81. 81 minus 1. So how much we will get? See, this is mr square by 2 into 81 minus 1 by 9. 81 minus 1 means 80. 2, 80 cancels means 40. So it becomes 40 mr square by 9. So 15th question, it will be first option. Okay, so that is about the 15th one. Next question number 16, what they are asking, see. A solid cylinder and a hollow cylinder, both of the same mass and same external diameter, means both are having same mass, same diameter means they are having same radius, are released from the same height at the same time on an inclined plane. One is a solid cylinder, another one will be hollow cylinder. One thick pipe you are taking, that will be solid cylinder. Hollow pipe you are taking, that will be hollow cylinder. Thick pipe will be solid, thin pipe will be hollow cylinder. Both rolls down without slipping. Which one will reach the bottom first? Okay, so here there is an inclined plane. Here one solid cylinder, another one will be hollow cylinder. Both are released from there. Then which one will take, for example, this is the inclined plane. Okay, so this is the inclined plane. here one will be solid cylinder, another one will be hollow cylinder. Here we are releasing from here, they are coming down, which one will come to the, this is inclined plane. From that end, if you are observing from that end, only this part will appear for you. This is that part. It is like this inclined plane. From here, one body is solid and hollow cylinders are released, which will come to the bottom, that is the earlier. So here what will happen means, time to come to the bottom, T is equal to 2h by g into 1 plus k square by r square. This is the formula. Time to come to the bottom, T is equal to root 2h by g into 1 plus k square by r square. So for solid cylinder, k square by r square is equal to 1 by 2. For hollow cylinder, k square by r square is equal to 1. We will substitute that values here. They are releasing from the same inclined plane, from the same height at the same time. All are same only. So h value is same. This t value is proportional to root of 1 plus k square by r square. T proportional to 1 plus k square by r square. So for solid cylinder, SC I am using, is equal to square root of 1 plus 1 by 2. Here some constant value will come, that is common for all of that. 1 plus 1 by 2 will be root 3 by 2. This value will be 1.5. For hollow cylinder, root of 1 plus 1, this value will be root 2. So, solid cylinder, it is taking less time. Hollow cylinder, root 2 value is more when compared to root 1.5. So, hollow cylinder is taking more time. Solid cylinder is taking less time. Understanding? So, then what will happen? Which will comes first? Which will comes earlier means, it is taking less time, na? It is coming earlier. So, solid cylinder will comes earlier. So, answer for this will be 16.4. Time to come to the bottom, h is same. So, t proportional to root 1 plus k square by r square. For solid cylinder, k square by r square is 1 by 2. Hollow cylinder, k square by r square is 1. If we substitute, we will understand solid cylinder will comes to the bottom in the less time. So, answer will be solid cylinder 16th. It will be 4th option. Next. Question number 17. What they are asking, see. Center of gravity of a body is the point at which the weight of the body acts. Center of mass coincides with the center of gravity if the earth is assumed to have infinitely large radius. That is second statement. To evaluate the gravitational field intensity due to any body at any external point, the entire mass of the body can be considered to be concentrated at its center of gravity. The radius of gyration of any body rotating about the axis is length of the perpendicular dropped from the center of gravity of the body to the axis. Which of the following pairs of statements is correct? If you observe the first point, center of gravity of a body is the point at which the weight of the body acts. That is correct statement only. In the that first statement is correct only. Center of gravity means the point where the total weight of the body is acting, that will be called center of gravity. Second statement, you see, center of mass coincides with the center of gravity for small bodies. If you take very big bodies, they are taking earth. Earth size will be very large. For it, center of mass and center of gravity locations will not be same. They are saying both will be at the same point. So, second statement will be wrong. First statement will be correct. Third statement, if you take, to evaluate the gravitational field intensity due to any body at any external point, the entire mass of the body can be considered to be concentrated at its center of mass, not at the center of gravity. So, third statement is also wrong. Fourth statement, the radius of gyration of any body rotating about any axis is the length of the perpendicular dropped from the center of gravity of the body to the axis. This statement will be correct. So, fourth statement will be correct. So, 1 and 4 are given in the first option. So, 17th question, first option will be the answer. 17th, it will be first option. These two statements are wrong. Here, center of mass should be there. Here, both will not coincide for very large shaped bodies. Next, question number 18. Question number 18, what they are asking? A thin circular ring of mass M and radius R is rotated about its axis with constant angular velocity omega. Two objects, each of mass small m, are attached gently to opposite ends of a diameter of the ring. The ring now rotates with angular velocity. So, one ring is there. Its mass is m. It is rotating about this axis, like this, with some angular velocity. Now, two masses are attached at the two ends. Now, about the same axis, if it is rotating, what will be the its angular velocity? This question will be same problem, already repeated problem, problem number 9 in the CET. So, problem number 9 in the same, here, NEET, not in the CET, same question. So, option for this will, here also, angular momentum will remains as the constant. L1 is equal to L2, I1 omega 1 is equal to I2 omega 2. Here, this will be m r square into omega. Here, these two masses also added. So, m r square plus small m r square for this body. For this body, small m r square into omega 2. So, r square will cancel. Then, omega 2 is equal to m omega by m plus 2m. Okay? with this we'll stop now. So 18th question, it will be fourth option. Okay, we'll continue in the next class, sir.